The Texas Aviation Hall of Fame was established in 1995 through a resolution from the 74th Texas Legislature and signed by then-Governor George W. Bush to honor famous aviators who are Texans and famous Texans who are aviators. There's currently 80 individual members recognized in four categories: trailblazers and explorers, military aviators, innovators and entrepreneurs, and leaders. The 2019 Texas Aviation Hall of Fame induction ceremony took place April 12th to honor its newest members. Among those inducted was legendary NASA flight director, the late Chris Kraft, father of mission control. Also inducted that evening was Dr. Peggy Whitson, the first female astronaut to take a spacewalk from the International Space Station. We were honored to speak to both these aviation heroes on the evening of their induction.
Gilruth picked me as one of the original 27 engineers in 1958, and I've been running ever since, till I retired in 82. It was a real challenge. Every day was a new day in engineering and development. Every day was wonderful. I woke up every day glad to go to work and sorry to leave when I went home. I worked all day, 7 days a week, and I enjoyed every moment of it. It was a real tribute to the country to have its young people, of which I was not, working on the program. And so I'm going to say that today. That's the one point I want to make. The age of my organization of 750 engineers and scientists and women was 26 in 1965. And it was the young people that made Apollo successful. And that is not emphasized because I think it would have some effect on bringing more people back into the space program. You're going to have them if you're going to go back to the moon.
Well, I think the most inspiring thing about being in space is the view and the perspective that you get of our planet. You know, seeing this very thin atmosphere, how large, you know, we see it as when we're standing down here on the planet, and seeing how thin our atmosphere is gives you this whole appreciation for this ecosystem inside that atmosphere. And on board the space station, we're generating a synthetic atmosphere, and recognizing how hard that is makes you want to protect the atmosphere we've got down here on our little spaceship Earth. But the other thing that I find very amazing and inspiring is looking out and seeing the thousands and thousands and thousands of stars, and that's just in our galaxy. And then there are billions of galaxies. And it's just, to me, incredibly mind-boggling, the scope, the scale, the perspective of what space is, and it's very exciting.
This is Ashley Graves, and we have had a fantastic time at the Lone Star Flight Museum. To learn more about it, go to lonestarflight.org and discover a fantastic place just a few minutes' drive away from where we all love to live, work, and play, in Nassau Bay.